Mr. Jerk, check 1, 2.
What up?
What up? And we're on.
Wait. Welcome to the Low East Side.
Yeah, welcome. This time we're on the way to good food, and I'm walking here around the Lower
walking
East Side.
Walking like you talk it.
Walking like you talk it. With one of my most favorite street artists in the world, I would say, Mr. Jerkface. Thank you so much, man, for the time.
Man, you know what time it is. I'm happy to help. What up?
Okay, so my
hold
first.
Up, hold up. How you doing, man? If you get him, don't get his face. He's a tiger. This is right, easy.
Alright,
this man. Is Tino.
Hey, good to meet you, bro. Tino. Hey, good to meet you.
He's all we came out from over here.
See you, man.
In a minute.
You can try once again, Mr. Jerkface. One of the coolest street artists in the world. I don't even need an introduction for that. I mean, we're walking down New York streets. That's where you're from.
Yeah.
And what does a life or a normal day of a New York street artist or an artist look like?
Work. All I do is sketch. That's my main objective, is to bang out sketches, as many as possible.
Sketching, painting, thinking about things. Just.
See, you got me mixed up with Mr. Face. I'm Mr. Jerk.
Oh man.
Here's the thing. I do the sketching and Mr. Face does the painting.
Okay.
I'm giving you the exclusive. Like, I'm giving you more than, which like a lot of people don't know. They just assume that this guy does all, like it's just one person. There's more than one person.
Amazing.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got you.
So in that sense, I do a lot of the sketching. I'm the style.
Okay.
I'm the guy with the ideas. And this guy, Mr. Face, he's the painter.
Okay.
So we work as a team. It's like a symbiotic kind of thing, because I have no time to be heading up the wall, to be doing, like, the shit that he's really good at, he does. And the shit that I'm really good at, I do.
Okay.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, it does.
Because I don't, it's one thing to do my sketch, and it's a whole nother thing to hit the wall. That shit, that makes, I have no desire to do that. I'd rather just create. But this guy is obsessive, so he wants to get the sharp lines, he wants to make sure everything is super, super clean. Yeah, it's better if he does that, so, yeah.
So it's basically a team of your own, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so it's more the studio that's your kind of workplace, or is it street?
See, I'm on the street. I've been walking around the Lower East Side, I'm paying attention to what's going on. So whether it's this wooden door, or this tagged up, broken up ATM machine, I'm peeping my environment and I'm being inspired by my environment. Not so much other artists' work at all, to be honest with you, but really I'm just getting inspired by the city that I love.
Wow.
I fucking love this city.
And you actually feel at work, because you said you work. Does it feel like it work for you?
A little bit. It's a little bit of work when, you know, working with Mr. Face is the work part.
Okay.
Trying to make it make sense to him, that's the hard part.
Okay.
Me doing what I do, just be like working on my sketches, that's not work. That's just something that I naturally come up with. You get what I'm saying?
But I got you.
To be able to go, Mr. Face, I need it this way, I need it that way. Like, being able to communicate with him is more work than anything else.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay. And how does it work when you have an exhibition or something like that? That's how does the teamwork work together?
But the thing is, people don't see me.
Okay.
They don't see me, they see him. So they just assume he's the whole entire entity.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got you.
And so I really don't give a shit who thinks what, because they're gonna make up whatever the fuck they wanna make up anyway. You get what I mean? So Mr. Face, because he's painting the idea, and I have to ask you a question, like, What's more important, the idea or the painter?
I got you, yeah.
You need both parts.
I mean, that's the thing. When an artist comes to a certain level, he usually, you know, has a team of production. He's an executive producer, right? Or something like that. Do you feel like that makes sense to you? Or?
Well.
Or a creative director? What would you? Or are you just an artist?
I'm just an artist.
Just an artist,
just,
yeah.
Like, and that's the thing, like, we start adding all this extra philosophy, when at the end of the day, when you walk by a Jerkface piece, within seconds you understand it. Like, all the backstory that it took to create it and who did what and that kind of thing, that's not what resonates. I'm not there to explain it to you. He's not there to explain it. But here we are. You know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to give you an idea of it, but like, just artists. I'm the artist, he's the painter.
Okay. You know what
I'm saying?
Like, I got
who's
you.
Who's the artist? I'm the artist. Who's the painter? He's the painter.
Okay.
Now, I mean, like, he has technical skill. I'll give you that. Paint the shit out of a wall. He can paint the shit out of a canvas. But this is my style he's painting. Okay. You get what I'm saying? But then on the other hand, I don't paint that well. I don't have a desire to be on a ladder. I don't have a desire to be sitting in a fucking studio for hours at a time, or doing a wall for 2-3 days at a time in the sun. Man, not interested.
Okay.
So just take my idea and do it like I said to do it. Yeah. You get what I'm saying?
Because yeah, I got you.
I don't want your style seeping into my style. I gave you this. You get what I'm saying? So that's pretty much the tug of war.
How about being an artist in New York City? You know, it's such an art city. Is it an advantage because the infrastructure is here, or on the other side is a disadvantage because, you know, all the competition is so saturated and so on?
I mean, now you just do your own thing.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not really paying attention to what everybody else is doing.
Yeah.
I'm just making sure my shit is together. You know what I'm saying? I'm making sure his lines are straight, his lines are tight. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm making sure, like, I'm doing my job. I'm making sure I'm doing my job to the best of my ability.
Yes.
The shit that I'm responsible for, and making sure that he's doing what he's supposed to do.
Okay.
If you look at the walls, like, I give it to him, like, he paints the shit out of the walls. Like, he really, he puts his heart into it.
Yeah.
As if it's his own. And that's hard to find. So, you know, when we first met, we just had an understanding. You
okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So, I'm the artist. He's the painter. But we need each other because in order for you to find out Jerkface, we both have to make sure we're doing our part. And so the New York art scene, is it oversaturated? I don't think so. I think there's walls for everybody.
I know.
But you gotta get busy and it's all constantly changing.
So how does your creative process, let's talk about how you work, how you actually, does an idea come to life, basically? Where do you write notes, how often, you know?
So this is how an idea happens. You have an idea, you do a sketch.
Yeah.
So for me, I have a glass table, and on the glass table, you can see through it, there's another table on it.
Okay.
So I'll do a sketch, put it on the bottom of the table, and then I'll sketch again on a different piece of paper over that sketch.
Okay.
So I'm building within my idea. And the way you do it is you start with like almost like a lump of clay and you refine it and you do it over and over and over and over. And whatever flaws that you see, you walk away from it, you look at it again and you're like, okay, this could be better, this could be tighter, and you revisit it. You revise until you look at it and you're like, you can't find anything wrong with this shit. You get what I'm saying?
Okay.
So you keep going until you like, you gotta be your own worst critic in a sense. You gotta find the whackness in your own work.
I got you.
And sometimes, I can't speak for other artists, but I can say early in my career, I wasn't so refined in looking at my work and being so honest about it.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying? Like, I'm not gonna say I was doing good enough. I'm saying, like, over time, you learn to look at your work differently and better and saying, okay, honestly, that part is weak and I need to fix it. And so you keep doing that and doing that and doing that until you get to a stronger piece. But you can stop at any point.
Yeah.
But it's like, how much do you care? How much do you want to make this piece stand out in a way where it's truly flawless?
Okay.
So when somebody encounters a Jerkface piece, they're looking at it. If they like it, they like it. But what if they hate it? They gotta find it. They gotta find the piece. They gotta find the Achilles heel. But if I find it before they find it, and I hide it, or I improve on it,
okay,
then you can try to hate, but you can't deny it. You can't deny. You know, you want to make an undeniable piece. Like, he did this, he did that, but fuck, I gotta respect this shit. He killed it. You get what I'm saying? So that's my style. Like, I'm gonna keep going in. It's a very obsessive style.
Okay.
I'm gonna keep going in and moving this around and moving that around. And it might just be a line. And people have worked with me, they're like, who's gonna notice that? Well, you're gonna notice it if I don't do it.
Okay.
Because it's the little tiny details
that make the entire picture.
What's that old saying? The details, the devil's in the details. So it's like a thousand little cuts that I'm doing to create this piece that when you see it, it evokes.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying? So in that sense, I'm doing all of that behind the scenes. Like I'm, like I could give a fuck. Like I don't, like again, I don't need to be the guy who's like, oh. I'm the guy who did the wall. I'm the guy who did this. I'm doing this interview and breaking it down, but like, this is a rarity. You get what I'm saying? And this is going overseas, so, you know, it's a whole different audience. It's a whole different type of, you know, it's a whole different type of respect. So it's like, New York is, it's like a little campus. You know what I'm saying? People know.
Yeah.
And you know that old saying when they go, those that know, don't tell, and those that tell don't know.
Yeah,
that's what New York is. You know, everybody got something to say.
That's and a
they
smart
just,
one.
They really just don't know. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't know. You're gonna find out from me, but then you're gonna find out from my work. My work speaks. You get what I'm saying? Like, I could say whatever. I could say a whole lot. I could speak a whole different language, but my work has its own language, and that's what resonated enough for you to reach out and be like, yo, let's talk. You know what I'm saying?
So. Amazing. Have you got a secret weapon?
I just gave it to you.
I mean.
I literally just gave you my 7 herbs and spices and you said, yeah, but do you have a secret weapon? My secret weapon is my ability to find the weakness in my own work. You get what I'm saying?
I needed a quotation.
Oh, okay, yeah. That's my secret weapon. I'm looking at my own shit and digging out the whackness in it.
Wow.
Pretty much. And not, the other part is, my work isn't static. You get what I'm saying? If you look at my early shit, and then look at my shit now, if you have, let's just say you have like freshman eyes, like you're new to this, you think it all looks the same.
Yeah.
But then you look at like, what I'm doing now as compared to what I'm doing later, it's two different things. But it's still under the same umbrella of my style. You get what I'm saying?
So you just evolve, basically.
Yeah, I'm not doing the same exact thing over and over and over, and that's no shade. That's just not what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking to evolve the work. Have you ever been in Freeman Alley before?
No, man.
Shit, you can't come to the Lower East Side. Oh, look at this. Don't believe everything you think.
Makes sense.
You get what I'm saying?
Yep.
Oh, look at this one. Too many humans, not enough souls.
The elevator was down.
Think about that for a second. Too many humans, not enough souls.
Yep.
So as I'm walking through the city, I'm listening. I'm being inspired. I mean, even a little bit of advice of like, don't believe everything you think. Because your mind will play tricks on you. Your mind will have you believing all types of shit. The media will have you believing all types of shit. Shit, you being in New York and us having this conversation, the media may not want that to happen, but here we are.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? We're thinking for ourselves. So in that sense, the city reminds you. So I'm paying attention to just everything that's going on and how that happens reflects in my work. And not so much in a technique or I got my own style, but I still got to be inspired by the place that I love. You get what I'm saying? So this is Freeman Alley. A little bit of everything in here.
Love it. So it's the city that inspires you. It's not like some artists, you know, like street artists, they need to go somewhere to nature, to the ocean or something like that, you know?
No, it's the city.
It's the city.
It's the city, and it's the foundation of my childhood. You know, it's the Saturday morning cartoons. It's the good times of my life. You get what I'm saying? It's like the days I was playing Super Mario, the days I was playing Mike Tyson's Punch Out, the days I was, you know, sitting around watching cartoons and eating cereal. So, my style is embedded in that in a way where, like, yo, this was a happier time in my life. This is what that old Wu-Tang shit, like, that's when everything was so simple. Now everything is all complicated. You know, you gotta, just a bunch of unnecessary foolishness that you gotta adhere to. This is cool. That's different.
Do you have a, an ultimate goal as an artist? when you say to yourself, wow, this is it, that's it?
Do I have an ultimate goal as an artist?
I guess it's not the money or, you know, the fame or whatever.
I'll be honest with you, if it was the money and the fame, I would have gave up a long time ago. That's no reason to do anything. Money and fame, that's not it. And I feel like a lot of people I've interacted with in the past, you know, if you're driven by money and you're around me, I feel like at some point there's a price to make a left. At some point there's gonna be a price.
Price tag attached to it.
For you to cross me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you're so involved with the money, so when that comes, if somebody's like, yo, I give you this X amount to shit on Jerk. You get what I'm saying?
I do.
But on another note, like, I can't be driven by the money. All I can be driven is, I'm driven to impact. Mm-hmm. That's what I want to do. I want to impact more. Mm-hmm. So when you come across a Jerkface piece, you're floored, you're moved. Something is a vote. You get what I'm saying? But I'm in it for the long game, the marathon. I'm not in it for the short stuff. That shit is old. That's why my work is constantly evolving.
Nice.
That's telling you that I'm in this for real. I'm not playing with it. We're gonna play. I'm not playing with it. Oh shit, you better run.
We got all these microphones.
Welcome to New York, baby.
So back to the interaction, you know, your work is mainly in the streets.
Yeah.
Also, of course, in the galleries, etc. But the interaction that is important to you, do you go like randomly and look at the people reacting to your artwork, or it's more like the online shit?
Nah, I'm here for it.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you've ever been to a wall when somebody's painting it, but, you know, when Mr. Face is out there getting busy, I'm out there.
Yeah.
You'll see me out there, like, I'm right there. We're there for the people.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? We're there for, like, again, if you're walking past a Jerkface piece, the objective is when you walk by, you're like, damn. You know what I'm saying? We want you to be impacted naturally, not because it's a Jerkface. You probably see that as a Jerkface before you even see the signature or the name. None of that shit matters. What matters is what it made you feel. You get what I'm saying?
Got
so
you.
We're out there, and he's painting, and I'm out there, I'm like, go on the IG page, one of the videos up there shows the experience. Like, the people are out there. They're bringing their kids, they're kicking it, we're having a super dope experience, we're just having a great day as we build the wall. It's not just some, we don't go promoting it, that's the other thing. Like, we're not like, hey everybody, we're going to see. Hey everybody, Mr. Face is painting the wall. Like, no, we're not doing that. But somehow, some way, like I was saying earlier, New York knows.
New York knows.
So all of a sudden they're like, yo, there's like a little like small network. Yeah. And so like one person know that the wall is being painted, there's another person, next thing you know, there's a crowd at the wall. You know what I'm saying? But then at the same time, it's organic. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, and in the era of, you know, like social media, it's so much easier, you know, to reach millions of people basically in a second. And how is that important to you?
Wait, what'd you say?
How is important for you, you know, like the digital change that you basically, as an artist now, are not speaking only to New Yorkians, you know, you're speaking basically to the whole world. So basically, what does like digital media or whatever, social media, mean to you as an artist? Is it just a tool or is it media or? Yeah.
Whether you walk by it or scroll by it, same shit. Okay. You understand? Like, ideally, you want to see it in person. Like, Instagram's cool, Facebook is cool, and Twitter's cool, digitally is cool. Shit, even a photograph of it, that's okay. But ideally, you want to see it in person.
Uh-huh.
And even better, maybe you can see it as it's being done. You understand? Like, how many jerkface pieces have you seen?
Quite a lot, but not that many. I mean, dozen, maybe a bit more.
Have you seen this one?
On Instagram, you see?
Yeah. Now let's ask you this. You've seen this on Instagram.
I would love to see.
Now you've seen it in person. Which one feels better?
Of course the real life, of course.
Look at that.
That's street art, it's not Instagram art, so.
We'll stand here for a second. This is the old Lasso Pizza. This is a classic wall. How'd you sound and all that?
Are you here?
For this one?
Yeah.
No, I'm here for most of them, but I wasn't here for this one. Every wall he's on here, I've been present for, but for this one, no.
So you...
And that doesn't help. You get what I'm saying? So people start thinking like, oh, this dude, that's him. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got you.
So
it's Mr. Jerkface, basically.
But it's like, everybody has a piece of the story. Everybody has a piece of the story. You got a piece of the story? Other people got a piece of the story. Very few people have the truth.
Okay. Makes sense. You reference basically, as you said, a lot of cartoons, a lot of things that meant something to you in your life.
Yeah.
Is there a book or a movie that like really made a significant impact on you?
My sketchbook.
Your sketchbook.
My blank sketchbook. Do you see the opportunity in that?
Such a good answer, bro. Strong. And if you could choose any artist, living or dead, for 24 hours just to be him or her, who would that be?
That's a good ass question. I wasn't expecting that one. Let's walk real quick. Who would I be?
Era, future, past.
You know? Because I spent so much time refining this living experience that we're in right now, that if I start looking at other people, like, if I'm looking for other people and others, that's just confusing to me. You get what I'm saying? I'm already trying to make sense of what this current experience is. To start mixing in other people's philosophies, ideologies, thought processes. That shit is just, yeah, no bueno. Whoops, excuse me.
And my very last question, unfortunately. What advice would you give to 20-year-old self, Mr. Jerk, a few years ago?
Honest with you, yo. Do exactly what you was doing. Understand what I'm saying? Because if my 20-year-old self didn't do the shit it did back then, we wouldn't be walking here today. There's no need, I have no regrets, you know what I'm saying? So there's no need to go switching shit up, changing shit up. Like, my trajectory, my path, my journey, what it's been and what it's about to be,
yeah.
I'm good with it. So I would be like, yo, matter of fact, I wouldn't even say shit. I would just see it. I'd see my 20-year-old self. I'd be more of an observer, but I wouldn't talk. I wouldn't say it. I wouldn't say anything. You know what I'm saying? I really wouldn't want my 20-year-old self to see future me, because I don't want to interrupt anything. You get what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to. I don't want to disrupt it. I want it to be exactly what it is right now.
Wow, super strong, Mr. Jerk. Thank you so much for your time.
Tino, brother.
So good to meet you. So good for this talk and walk.
Yeah, how long is this gonna take to come out? I got one more wall to show you. You got time?
Yeah, let's do that. Absolutely.
Yeah, it's literally up the block. We're going to like two blocks up. I see you.
There we go.
You think we don't know? We know.
New York knows, as you said before.
Yeah, New York paying attention. It's all good.
To be really honest, I didn't know. It's two people, Mr. Jerkface. But it's not that much known about you. Absolutely.
Most people don't know.
Yeah.
Like, people have pieces of the story. Like I said, the people that think they know are doing all the talking. The people that really know
are quiet.
They ain't saying nothing. You know what I'm saying? And I like it that way. I don't need everybody to know every single aspect and everything. Because then, then the fun is gone. You get what I'm saying? Like, that's not what this is about. Like, you start dissecting shit and then it's over. Like, that old fable of the goose and the golden egg. Like, get your eggs.
Yeah.
Stop worrying about, like, what's inside. You're gonna fucking kill the goose. And with all this information, you know, you got the internet, you got Google, you got this, you got... Yo, just enjoy it. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you wanna have a slice of pizza, but you worrying about every single last ingredient, eat a salad, yo. Like, you don't want pizza. Like, we already know off top it ain't healthy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We eat because it's delicious. But if you want to start breaking it down and doing all this other, you're missing the whole point of it. You're missing the whole point. And as creative and as young creatives, start doing all those shortcuts, start being static in your work.
Street,
because it's constantly changing. Like, that wall that I just showed you, it's been at least five different pieces on that wall.
Okay.
If not more or less, I don't know, but it's constantly changing, constantly.
This, like, wall, you mean five pieces of your art or somebody else?
Yeah, five different. No,
of yourself.
Of mad different artists, but like, that wall is constantly changing.
Yeah.
Mr. Face painted that wall mad times.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? He painted this wall mad times. Before this, there was a donut.
The wall like this, are you commissioned to do it, or it's just art? Are you doing it for someone?
It's always changing.
Always changing.
Yeah, nobody's gonna tell. Nobody's gonna tell me what to do. No. I tell Mr. Face what to do. Yeah. But nobody's gonna tell me what to do.
How about all the management stuff, or, you know, like the stuff? Of course, one thing is painting, coming up with ideas. The second is kind of selling them or communicating them, you know, like.
That's also ever changing. That, you know, everybody you deals with it a different way. Some people are more professional than others. It's just on you to know your shit. Period. Don't let anybody tell you what you already know. You gotta know, because if you don't know, then they'll tell you. They're gonna find your Achilles heel and work that. You get what I'm saying? So, and I can't give you just a general answer, but I'm saying in every single person and every business you encounter, every person you work with, they all have their own agenda. So you just need to know your shit confidently. Like, know it, not kind of know it, like, really know it. That way, you can't be remixed. Period.
Period.
Excuse me, what are your thoughts on this wall? Like, what do you think of this wall? Yeah, how you feel about it? We're working on a piece about this artist.
Okay, yeah, I was about to ask if it was you, if you made it. Because you guys are shooting out here.
What's up?
Y'all trying to film this?
Cool. Wow, yeah.
Nah, just see the camera.
Oh,
I'm just asking a question.
No, wait, no, I'm not trying to. to be aggressive. Yeah.
Okay. Hey, I'm not, don't worry, I'm not on TMZ. I ain't trying.
What are your thoughts on the wall?
I mean, like, honest truth?
Yeah, be honest.
I don't see nothing special about it. I just see Mickey Mouse.
Yeah.
You don't see? I see two images of him, yeah. I do. Mm-hmm. That's it, really.
But you don't, like, when you look at it, you don't feel anything? Like, are you looking at it more from the stance of, like, technically? Or are you just, in a sense
of... I'm a huge fan of art.
Okay, so what's some of your favorite art?
But see, like, I like abstract art. Mm. You know, and, you know, things that's just a little, something that's different, you know?
Right.
I get my mom rambling, because, you know, it could be like, all right, for example, this could be like a, I want to say a star.
Mm-hmm.
But the star, to me, it could be like, you know, basketball or future or something, and in his eyes could be a beautiful woman, you know.
Yeah.
Everybody got their own perception of it.
So with this
Mickey Mouse, like us in the past 2 days, I don't seen about, I want to say at least 100 people take a picture of this.
You saw 100 people
at
take
least,
a picture of that.
At least, and it probably was way more than that.
And the whole point of it is how vote. With all this negativity that's going on in the world, as you walk in, you see one positive thing. It don't have no agenda to it. It don't have no lights on it. You just either like it or you don't like it. And if you don't like it, that's mad cool. You get what I'm saying? Because it's your right to have your taste, your preference. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it's also, sometimes people just like, this guy just gotta work. You know what I'm saying? Or I'm dealing with this, or I'm dealing with that. But, oh shit, I grew up with Mickey.
But Mickey, that's why you taking a picture of it?
No, I created that.
You drew this?
Yeah.
Respect, bro. Respect, bro.
They trying to get us to, because he the super of the building.
Yeah.
Everybody keep asking, could they paint over that? We say no. That's a no-no. You cannot paint over that.
Nah.
Nobody. Did anybody come to ask us, could we? No. That don't get painted over. Nobody.
Because it's
love. He don't want painted that.
I
didn't
know that, bro.
It's all about love. Like, it's cool to pick, the fact that you was like, I don't see what's special, it's crazy that dialogue from the thing. Bigger.
You gotta come back and touch it up, man.
Yeah.
You gotta
at some
see.
Point, it's just time. But you see how cold it was, now it's warm again.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? So it's just a matter of time.
Yo, I swear to God, every day at least 40 people taking pictures in front of that man.
That's what he just said, yeah.
But think about how much negativity is in the world. So you got 5 seconds of positivity and then you gotta go back to the bullshit.
Yeah.
It's more about that than it is about like, all I see is Mickey. You gotta see, like,
I got what you're saying, bro.
The 40 people that you saw, the 100 people that you saw, that's 150 people that got a smile.
Yeah,
it's more about that than it is about, like, this or that. But at the end of the day, you and I can have this conversation. You get what I'm saying? And that goes a long way.
True.
And that, to me, is so much more important. I'm so glad we had a chance to talk. Sirs,
hey, what's your name, bro?
Jerk. Peace, y'all.
Hi.
Let me get out of here, man.